Good morning, everybody. Right now we have an example 5. They ask you, in the figure, HG is parallel to LK. HG is parallel to LK, mean that the segment of line in these two triangles here, HG is parallel to LK, okay? And to see the sign here mean that it's parallel. And you know that these two lines here mean that these two lines are congruent, okay? Then, first we have to identify here that we have here this side is corresponding to this side and it's congruent, okay, because I have two lines here. This side here is corresponding to this side here of the triangle. I'm gonna be congruent too. And this side is corresponding to this side of the triangle. I'm gonna be congruent too, okay? This one called triangle 1, triangle 2. That's only to identify sometimes. First, we have three congruent sides. But what about the angles? What about the angles? Okay. You know that this angle here, you see this angle, remember, when we have this angle, it's called vertical. When you have vertical angle, mean that this angle here is gonna be congruent to this angle here. In another word, it's gonna be equal. Okay, this angle here is gonna be equal to this angle. That means it's congruent to this angle because they are vertical. Remember, vertical angle is when you write an angle that cross that two line cross, this line with the line cross, and these two angles are gonna be congruent. And the other angle here is gonna be congruent too. Okay. Right now, we have another thing that is given for us to us that this side here is gonna be parallel to this side here. What does that mean? That if we do two lines that are parallel and it's crossed for a transversal here. If you remember, when we have this angle in here and this angle in here, it's called interior angle. Okay, alternate interior angle. And with these two lines, when you have these two lines is parallel, mean that these two alternate interior angle is gonna be congruent, okay, by definition. That means that this angle with this angle in here are congruent because there are alternate interior angle, okay? Let me have it here. Angle H JG is congruent to the angle KJR. Mean the angle H J G is congruent to the angle K J R. because I told you before, it's are vertical, and because they are vertical angle. The angle HK angle H and the angle K is going to be congruent because there are alternate interior angles. If we see here, it's parallel here, and you can see this angle in here compared with this angle in here. It's the same thing that we have this angle in here. This angle in here, the angle J with the angle L, there are alternate interior angle. And because this line here is parallel to this line here, they're supposed to be congruent, mean equal. Then angle G, the angle G is congruent to the angle L. Okay. Right now, we had three angles that are congruent and the three sides are congruent. Let's go to write HG, that's to be the angles. And let me write here the side. Now, let me write here alternate interior angle. Some alternate interior angle. Interior. Alternate interior. Because they're alternate interior and these two sides here are parallel, that means that these angles are congruent. Okay, I had to write 1, 2, 3 to identify that they are congruent. Right now, size. Okay, HG same like HG. Is gonna be congruent to KJ, to the size KJ. That means that AG is gonna be congruent to HJ is going to be congruent to KJ. Okay. HJ is going to be congruent. HJ is going to be congruent to FL. And JG is going to be congruent to JL. Yeah. JG is going to be congruent to JL. You have the three sides, the three lines, you're going to be congruent. Right now, you say that the triangle or this side here, we're going to call the triangle H-J-G. Is gonna be congruent to the triangle KJL. You can see here, H is congruent to K. H is congruent to K. You had it. We mark here the two circle lines here and the angle. H congruent to K. J is congruent to J. You have the same name. Okay, because it's the same name. And G is congruent to L. G is congruent to L. So that's the way that you have to say that your triangle is congruent. Thank you.